does is she begins to evangelize right out of the gates. She runs right into town. Come see a man that told me everything about him. She got a hold of some living water that day. There may be someone here. Jesus has been right in front of you for a long, long time. But yet you've looked to satisfy what you feel are the needs in your life with other things. But yet you continue to get thirsty. You drink of things and get thirsty again. You eat things, but yet you're still hungry. You put things in your body and in your flesh and in your mind, but yet it only satisfies for a small season, and then you've got to continually put those things in again and again and again and again and again, but yet they don't satisfy you. Jesus would say, I'm right here, right now. You'll not thirst again if you drink of this water. Would there be a one here this morning that would say, Pastor, I'm tired of being thirsty and drinking of the wrong thing. I want water that's everlasting where I'll not thirst anymore. All eyes closed, heads bowed across this place just for a short amount of time. Pastor, I want living water. I want the real deal. Would there be a one here that say, Pastor, this is me? Just slip up your hand. It's me, Pastor. It's me. You can look up now. Pastor, I'm weary and well-doing. And I'm telling you, I just wish my season would get here, because I'm getting awful weary. The sun is beating down, the vines are overtaking my corn, and I'm so hungry for corn. See what happens if you lost focus on the ultimate high prize. You lost focus along the way. When you lose focus of that, then it's difficult to get there. Everyone standing to your feet. You just need a little encouragement till you get to your due season. You need to refocus on the season of reaping, harvesting. If you'll just make a bold statement by stepping out of your seat and coming forward, saying, God, I need help through these first seasons until I'm able to reap. Lord, I'm weary in my well-doing. Even sometimes on the point of fainting. You said in your word that I will reap in due season if I faint not. Very quickly, right now, get out of your seat and come so folks don't meet you. Come on. Come on. Who else? Come on. Miss Jessie, get up here, girl. Come on. I want to pray and encourage you. Come on. JR, come stand next to your bride. Now I want you to focus on the prize of the high calling. I refuse to faint. I refuse. I absolutely refuse to give up. Church folk, come around. Everyone else, come around. Gather around. People in their seasons in their life. Get all around them, in front of them, beside them. Thank the Lord for seeking. God, I know that there's a prize. I know that there's ripened fruit in me in my due season. But Lord, you know it's difficult in the season that I'm in right now. Don't. Father, I'm surrounded by more than conquerors. Between 4 and 4:30, we'll be working tomorrow all day. We'll probably be here at 9 in the morning. And there'll be activities throughout the entire day tomorrow. There'll be some visitations, some renovation, and some all different, you name it, and it'll be happening here tomorrow. We'll meet about 9 o'clock. Then on Tuesday, we'll meet again at 9 o'clock if you're participating in any of the events. We'll meet together for prayer and instruction. Susie, Miss Amy, is there anything that we need to announce as far as any help or anything in the next day or two? Thank you very much. Look forward to seeing you this evening.